All right, so. I don't know if I want us to introduce ourselves first and then intro, or what?
Let's introduce ourselves first.
Yeah, okay.
So, we'll say the clip starts now. So, my name is Chad.
My name is Amanda.
You may or may not know us from a podcast called The Secular Perspective. Mm-hmm. We tend to talk about secularism, religion, stuff like that. Lately, there's been a little politics involved since it's since it's an election year. But we do find news stories and stuff that tends to be a little more serious topics. And
Well, it's serious, but then we laugh at stuff.
And we try to make light of it because it is, some of it's pretty heavy stuff. We've talked about abortion. We've talked about the Duggars. Planned Parenthood. Well, that's abortion stuff. We just talk about all kinds of stuff that would sometimes have a little bit of a religious slant to it. And it's, you know, you can only talk about that so much. And we do tend to derail our own conversations. So this is going to be a little experiment. We're going to record this as a podcast and also do some videos, see how it goes. So with that being said, I'm going to cue our intro. All right, so that is our fun, I think fun anyway, intro music. That
it sounded like an Irish jig because it was coming out of your headphones. Oh. And, like, so it was hitting me. There's like this little tiny noise.
So I want to give credit to the guy that wrote that. That's actually just an edited version of a song that was about twice as long. It's what they call chiptune. I know you said it sounded kind of video gamey, mm-hmm. which is kind of the point of something like that. But the artist's name is Azure Flux, which, like, azure is like the color of the sky. Like, that's the color of blue is pronounced. It's azure. But he goes by Azure Flux. I found his found some of his music on the Free Music Archive, actually. You can go check him out. That song was actually called Intro.
I like that.
So I was like, you know what, I gotta hear this, because I was looking for a theme song for this. I was like, okay, it's actually fitting. But he did an album called Pocket Boy. I don't know if that's supposed to be a play on Game Boy or what that is, but you can find him there. I'll have a link to his page on the Free Music Archive. He's actually got several albums, a lot of chiptune type of stuff, which is that video gamey 8-bit, 16-bit yeah. kind of Nintendo-y type sound, which every now and then I do like. Like, it's just one of my little guilty pleasures. Sometimes I'll go listen to something like that because I'm a gamer. So, but this show, we are calling it Chad and Amanda Talk Shit About, and then it can be about whatever we want. We do tend to derail our conversations quite a bit.
Yeah, we need an outlet.
And we needed an outlet. So this is going to be that outlet. We can talk about whatever we want.
Mm-hmm.
We'll usually have some kind of a topic. We'll probably talk about news stories, like the off-the-wall news stories, I think, would be the best. Just some of that stuff that you look at and you're just like, what the fuck is this? Or something that makes me laugh, something that makes you laugh, whatever. Because we need some more fun stuff to talk about. I'm tired of talking about somewhat serious stuff all the time. Because I love me some dick and fart jokes.
Okay, gotta move the fan.
You gotta move the fan? Okay. Oh, goodness. You better now?
Yeah, I felt like Miss it was Wendy. In a shampoo
We'll start calling
commercial.
You Wendy. But anyway.
Damn, it's hot, too.
It's a little stuffy up in here. We've actually been... We just finished recording for the other show. And Amanda's got a lot of hot air, so this room's got pretty warm.
It got, yeah.
And we got a fan going
actually,
down
kinda,
on low.
I was kind of punch drunk in our last show. I'm coming down right now.
Oh, are you?
It's tough.
So we've got a few things here. not really a lot, but like I remember last week, after not last week, a couple of weeks ago,
right after our show,
right
I was like,
after.
Listen, I was like, look at this, and I sent Chad this link because that's how we talk over Facebook, pretty much. And it says Hitler has a micropenis,
which explains a lot, really, when it comes down to it.
That's what my husband said. He's like, I bet everybody's gonna be like, well, that explains World War II.
It was just a...
And he's like, I don't want people to say that. I want people to be like, oh, the all man's struggle relates back to his dick. You know?
Whatever.
He rolled his eyes at it. I was laughing. Okay, it's up for debate whether or not he has a micropenis.
Because, I mean, how did anybody find this out? Did they go dig up his corpse and look? Like, no, you know, honestly, did you read the article? Because,
yes.
Honestly, I did not read the article.
Oh,
I saved
you.
It. You fill me in on some penis. Wait, that
penis.
Sounded really bad. Let me retract that. Fill me in on what you learned about Hitler's penis.
Okay. The news outlets grabbed a hold of this and said, he's got a micropenis, that's what it means. Well, that's up for debate. What's not up for debate is, I want to say, I mean, his left testicle was undescended. One of his testicles was undescended.
Like just completely. So
it was,
up in his body still.
So
to the average person or a woman he would have been with, they reached out and grabbed, they would have felt just one nut.
It was one nut Hitler.
One nut Hitler.
And that's actually what Adolf means.
It's one nut.
When it's translated.
Wow.
No. Okay. And then they also
said. You had me
for
just a second.
No, I didn't. I didn't. So, and then, wait, what's the other?
You can scroll if you need to. Oh, we have, well, it
Hypospadias.
Hypospadias. I don't know how you pronounce that.
Hypospadias.
I don't know.
Whatever. It's that condition. It only means his urethra was on the underside of his penis instead of shooting out straight.
Oh, it
looking
went
at you like a bullseye.
Low or whatever.
Yeah, it came out. Well, basically, his urethra came out and took a dive and went underneath.
So
instead
rather
of
than so
straight
let's,
and sh-
let's say this is the we're doing this on video, so people that are listening to this instead of watching, I'm sorry, this is kind of a visual thing, but. So
I'm not touching your penis hand.
But I'm just saying, rather than come out this way,
yeah,
it would
through.
Come down more
yeah,
something
his
like
urethra,
that.
And then yeah. There, whoo,
okay.
He's peeing out the underside of his,
okay.
Of his penis.
Wow.
Shaft.
That's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Weird.
So we don't know if it was unusually small. They're saying this is from his doctor in prison noticed this.
Oh, okay.
And wrote it down on medical files. And they said it was documented somewhere else. With his doctor maybe, but this isn't new. This like there's been like even the British made fun of him and
yeah.
said he had like something wrong with his
yeah.
like penis back during World War II.
Well, yeah, you kind of would, but
well, who knows? It was like a rooted in fact a little bit.
Oh, I guess
mean,
now, yeah.
I think maybe something got out and it was like a rumor born halfway out of the truth.
Well, you know, that's how most rumors and stereotypes start. Is like you get that just that little bit and then it goes. Which I find really funny that this happened now because there have been with Trump in the news so much, there has been so
on
many,
his hands,
yeah. Which leads into he's like, oh, you know, if you got small hands, you must have a small penis, and man, you know, I'm surprised he didn't just flat out say, oh, it's huge. And I've never had a complaint in that department, but I'm surprised he didn't flat out say something like that. But or
no,
did
they
he,
were
did
talking
he?
About dick sizes
oh,
during
I know.
The GOP.
I didn't watch it. I refused to let my brain cells die by watching
it.
Them. But, you know, I saw highlights later or heard about it.
I wasn't surprised it devolved into, like, dick
I mean,
size.
That's seriously where we're at now. That's terrible. But I found it so funny that this story came out at the same time people were making all these Hitler comparisons. And then the dick size thing came out
it's
in
strategic.
The debate. I'm like, oh, my God, this stuff is all just lining up.
It's strategic.
Perfectly.
Like, let's say that right now.
But why? Like, I don't get it. Like. It's seriously, like, the GOP debates and the whole GOP party is, like, it's totally devolved to, like, high school, almost middle school mentality. Come, you know, May, we may be in elementary school and kindergarten. I don't know.
I don't know. It seems to be what people want. It scares me.
So I had two things here highlighted. Pretty much the same article. I think this is...
This, okay, the Men's Health article. It's called, Did Hitler Really Have a Micropenis? They get more scientific about it and say, it doesn't mean it was totally deformed. but it was deformed.
Yeah. But what I love about this, if you guys go check out this article, I'll have a link to it. They actually have just kind of a little line drawing of Hitler, but it's shaped like a dick. It's the head.
And then it's got
it's got the little mustache. Hitler stash and the comb over right at the top of the head. Oh my God. That's awesome.
Whoever made that is a genius.
Yes.
Who is it? Let's give a prompt.
Illustration by it's a guy by Barry Knobloch or Knoblach. It's K-N-O-B-L-A-C.
Barry Knobloch?
Probably not.
That's not a real name.
Barry Knobloch.
That's gotta be made up.
Because of the knob part, maybe.
I would almost search Barry Knobloch on Google and then search illustrator or something behind it or artist. Barry Knobloch artist.
You've gotta...
Because I'm predisposed to say that's not real.
He's on LinkedIn. That might not be the right one.
Artist after there.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. There's other Barry Knoblochs in the world, too.
That's
true. We're just being rude.
The Artist Armada. I don't know.
Well, could be.
I don't know. I'm not seeing really much of anything here popping up. I think it must be made up.
I'm holding out that it's real. I'm going to say
Okay. We don't know. If Barry, if you are a real person and you're out there, we're sorry for laughing, but that's kind of it's an unfortunate coincidence.
Is Barry short for anything?
I think Barry might be short for Bernard.
Bartholomew, maybe. Bernard, I can see that. Okay, I just wondered if it was a real name in its own right.
Yeah, I mean, I used to work with a guy that named Barry, and we just knew him as Barry. But I feel like he said his actual full name would have been Bernard.
I dated a guy, and his name was Randy, and I was just so sure his name was Randall. No, my name is Randy. It's on my birth certificate that way.
Was not short for anything.
I was like, you were given a nickname.
Well, it's like... You know, my name's Chad. So many people think it's short for Chadwick.
I could see how that...
And it kind of bugs me. It's never really struck me. But there's, very few people that I will let get away. And I have to already have a rapport with them that I will let get away. It's not like I really give them a lot of shit about it or anything. But it's just one of those, Otherwise, it bugs me, but there's two or three people that's one of my aunt's friends. And there's one girl that I work with.
They'd have to say it with a Victorian accent, Chadwick, or
yeah, maybe.
I'm sorry.
That's I don't know.
There was a lady I knew in the South, and she was you could tell she had had a cotillion, and she was such a Southern belle, and her name was Barbara, and I could not say it like that. I looked at her, and I had to say
Barbara.
I was like, Barbara. she was like, why? And I was like, I cannot say it any other way, Barbara.
I know why. They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Yeah, I don't know why.
That's why.
She was so upright and just proper.
Prim and proper.
Yeah.
Pretty funny. The only other real story that I even saved for us to talk about on this, because I figured past that we can just
BS. We're just gonna make up shit.
Yeah. Jared Fogle of Subway fame, air quotes fame, not so much anymore, but this hit home, literally hit close to home for us because
he's here
in Indianapolis, which is
Indianapolis. I thought he was more
He's in Central Indiana.
Okay.
I thought.
Wow.
Now, he went to college at IU Bloomington. Okay. That's where I don't know how much of the story you know, but the whole point of Jared's rise to fame was he did the Subway diet before it was the Subway diet.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Which was basically he would eat Subway. I don't know if he was eating it twice a day or just once a day, but it was at least once a day he was eating Subway, plus he was walking and stuff like that. Okay. Years ago, after he had already...
Oh, I had a chance to get a Subway cutout of Jared Fogle life-sized, and I regret that I don't own it right now. Because how much fun could you have with that? Ooh. Like, now?
Maybe. I don't know. That'd just be like one
more
thing.
He would be a Halloween decoration, I tell you that.
Yeah.
Nothing scarier. Didn't you always kind of think he was kind of scary?
He was kind of, he always had that, like, kind of a creeper vibe look to him.
Like, his robot smile.
Do you remember? I have a hard time picturing it now.
Oh, you need to look at it.
There's a picture.
Oh, he's not smiling.
He's not smiling in that picture. Oh, there he is. There's another one where he's smiling. Yeah, it's kind of a fake looking smile. But the reason I bring
it up. It's because he shows too much bottom teeth. Nobody does that.
Yeah.
Like, smile at me right now. I'm not going to show your bottom teeth like
that. Yeah.
And you're not going to line them up like that.
Yeah. Like, you have to really.
Uncanny.
Yeah. But the reason I bring that up is, you know, I worked down at IU Bloomington for a while.
Oh, did you meet him?
Oh, no. This was long after he was a thing. But I remember his whole thing was like, oh, I made a point to go to Subway and stuff like that. I had somebody point out to me, at least this is how I remember it. I may be wrong about this, but this is the memory that I have. Is somebody right at the edge of campus, I remember there being just this little hole in the wall Subway, which is most of them. I mean, they're small. You can fit them in wherever. But right above it was some apartments. And the person told me, he's like, you see right over there? That's where Jared used to live.
Above the Subway.
Yes.
In the apartment.
That's what I was told. Now, whether or not that's true is a whole other story.
I heard he would walk to it. But if he's just walking from
upstairs to downstairs, exactly. That's kind of my point.
Because that was the whole mythology.
It wasn't that he, I don't know that it was necessarily that he went out of his way to do it as much of it was convenient.
It was like, oh, turkey's my favorite, and I'll cut out mayo today. And then he's like, oh, my God, I'm losing weight.
All right. The chicks are going to line up. I don't know.
All right.
Anyway, but so, yeah, I don't think he really went out of his way to do it. I think it was just kind of a weird side effect that happened of the convenience of having a Subway right there.
I want to know who got a hold of who. Like, did one of his friends shout out to Subway, hey, this guy's losing a bunch of weight and I'll use the Subway? Or Jared himself contacted Subway like, I lost a lot of weight
and I love Subway, I want some free ones.
Yeah.
Like, sign me up, I'll be a spokesperson.
I wonder how that
I don't know why this is my Jared Fogle voice.
I know, you're giving us such a stupid voice.
I know. I'm college educated, damn it. Yeah. I went to IU.
It's a bad rep for IU right now.
I know. And it's terrible, and I apologize to everybody at IU.
You walked around that campus.
Oh, I did too. I mean, like I said, I worked there for about a year and a half.
Okay.
And had friends that went to school there. And that's how that's where my college party experience, like the two or three college party experiences that I had, happened at IU. Because I just went to, like, Ivy Tech, just like a state community college, because what I wanted to go to school for, there wasn't any local colleges, state colleges that were teaching that yet, which is like graphic design and stuff like what Cassie does.
Oh, okay.
And which I don't do anymore. I got all the way through it. Like, I got to the last class and was like, I'm sick of this. Like, I don't want this to be the rest of my life.
What, really?
Yeah. Mom and Dad were pissed.
Oh, my parents didn't pay for my
college. Oh, yeah. Oh, they were mad.
I made it through, and I made it through so efficiently, because I always knew I wanted to do journalism. I made it through so efficiently that I had to, like, make up two bullshit classes, because I had done so well in picking classes that cross-counted toward my requisites.
So you didn't have enough credits.
Yeah, they're like, you need to take a stress and relaxation. I'm like, I'm not kidding. I had to take a stress and relaxation course along with another bullshit, probably when I needed the lead. Real gross. Real fat. Anyhow, Jared, who may have this happen to him sometime in the future.
Yeah, which I think is going to happen. That's the whole point. Yeah, this is the reason that we do this show.
Because that was just okay.
Yeah, yeah, that was okay for her to do. Like, we started talking about Jared, and we're talking about people slitting throats now.
Yeah.
But which might bring it full circle. You never know. So, Jared, if you don't know, Jared Fogle was, everybody knows Jared. He was a Subway spokes guy. He got caught with child porn on his computer in his house. And then
when it first came out, they were like, no,
it's somebody else's, it's like, assistant.
It's his personal
something.
Assistant. Yeah. And so everybody believed that for a while. Then we're like, no,
it was actually him. But even more so, he got caught, like, he was secretly recorded or whatever, actually talking about encounters with kids, and, you know, the younger, the better, all this really weird, creepy shit. So, yeah, he's in jail now, and the point of the article is basically he's gained, like, 30, 40 pounds back. He looks
look heavier even making his way to the courthouse in that photo.
Like, he looks like shit, which, you know, if you're stressed, you're going to eat more. He's getting the mayo on the
Subway either now. Eat more or don't eat at all, and
he chose
turn into a skeleton. But they say he buys, like, pastries from the commissary. If you scroll down, I saw something. They're like, he's known to eat 8 in one sitting right up there between his...
Oh, wow. Yeah. Well, he's a stress eater, clearly.
He loves cake day in the dining hall twice a week and buys honey buns.
By the box. He's not going to make it out of prison.
Do you think?
Generally, from what I understand, like, child rapists and pedophiles and stuff like that usually have a lot harder time in prison because stick up for the kids and turnabouts, player fair play.
Right.
So that's probably what's going to happen. Yeah.
Oh.
Somebody had a little Facebook thing on here. They took a screenshot of. We have no clue who said it, but he says he has a little cushion for the pushing. He'll get in prison.
Wow. Yeah.
That's dark. And funny. They call him in prison. His nickname is Chomo, which is short for child molester. I've never heard of that one. But, yeah. They said he never ratted out the inmates who did it, but
they slap him across his cheeks to make his face red.
Oh my god!
That's fraternity shit, not prison shit.
No, this isn't. I wouldn't even say it was fraternity shit. No, fraternity shit. You're trying to be part of the group. They're doing this to him, shaming him.
Well, like the fraternity hazing, you know.
Yeah, but that would probably be more on your butt. I don't know if they would necessarily put marks on your face. If they're smacking him, I mean, they're making his face red, bitch slapping him. Basically.
Bitch slapping him.
Yeah. I mean, there. The inmate slapped him across the cheek several times and made his face red. He just stood there stunned and then ran out of the gym while inmates booed and called him by his prison nickname, Chomo, which is short for child molester. This, by the way, is an article from distractify.com. I'll have a link to it. But you know what? I think the best way to round this out, so I'm not sure how long we've been recording now.
Between, like, he deserves that, and then, like, oh, that's mean, you know?
Yeah.
I guess what gets me is, like, the line, like, then he ran out of the gym. I'm like, oh, he's like a little kid, like, just sad.
Can I stop it?
Yeah, that's what I think. And then I'm like, oh, that's not funny, you know? Yeah. And then...
But you got to keep in perspective. Prison's not meant to be fun.
Yeah, and then I think about, you know, the kids. And
right.
It's like, all right, the kids.
Yeah,
you know,
he's not going to get off light. He's going to go through some shit.
16 years he's got, and you say in those 16 years he's not going to make it.
I don't think he'll make it. Now, I don't know if... I remember his lawyers was trying to get, like, some kind of a stupid slap on the wrist type sentence.
Oh, yeah.
Like, something really ridiculous, and it didn't go through.
No.
But I don't know if... I'm sure there's probably, like, a time for good behavior type of deal.
Oh, yeah, it never says without the possibility of parole. So, of course, he's going to be paroled early, whether it be by a matter of months or a couple of years. Yeah, it's going to be.
That's really all we have to talk about that we had planned for today. I do think it would be kind of fun to tell some stories, though. I'm thinking of, you know, since it was IU.
I need the fan back.
You need the fan? Turn it back.
It's too much.
Yeah. You can set it to oscillate if you want. There you go. Right there, that one. Yeah, that one. There you go. Is that better?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'll deal with my hair and your face.
Whatever. That breeze does feel good kind of coming across here now.
God.
I'd open the window, but I don't want outside noise creeping in.
Your neighborhood looks quiet.
There's a lot of cops in my neighborhood.
Oh.
Like, they're right there. There used to be one right there.
Oh, really?
Yeah. There's a lot of cops in this neighborhood, so it's a quiet neighborhood. Oddly enough, there's still break-ins that happen sometimes. It happens.
Oh, yeah. So,
I had my TomTom stolen out of my car in my driveway because I forgot to lock it one night.
Oh, I always lock my car.
I always do, too. It's like, I don't remember what it was. Like, I had to go back for groceries. My hands were full with groceries or something, and I just forgot to go back and lock it. It's the one night that they decided to make the rounds. And, I mean, they didn't break into the car. Obviously, they just checked the handle, and it opened. And, like, hey, I had an iPod in there. They skipped it. They just,
really?
Yeah. Just grabbed what they saw real quick and moved on.
Hmm.
So, kind of made me mad. But now I got cars with built-in GPS, so steal that, motherfucker.
Like, challenge accepted. Your car is gone. Well,
my car's parked in the garage now, so. But no, I was thinking, I want to tell some stories, just good, at least one story that's kind of weird. From
is this your childhood stories?
No, this isn't a child. So this is more of like a college type time story. Just like one of the parties we went to. There was probably three or four really big parties. And there's like one story that I know that I, in that off chance that my friend and his wife would listen.
Is it that illegal?
No, it's nothing illegal, but there's some stories that I've been sworn to secrecy on that I cannot tell. That I'll tell you off
even air. without time, like the cushion of time.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I will tell you it off air. But if stuff could get back, and I don't want to get people in trouble.
All right.
But, not even anything bad, but it would just be really embarrassing.
Oh, I feel like that's just awful.
But it's a fun story, and I wish so bad that I could tell you. But there was like a couple of really good parties that we had down there. And he lived in an area called like Varsity Villas, which is like right
the off. Name sounds weird.
Yeah, it was just a bunch of little apartments. They were jam-packed in. These apartments were like kind of like three floors. You'd have your main floor, your basement, and then your upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And they were just right off campus. Like, they were right across the road from the football stadium. And they had kick-ass parties. But there was like five guys that lived in this apartment, essentially. Because there was like
three. Is that even legal?
Is that right? Yeah. Because there was two bedrooms upstairs, like two actual bedrooms. And then in the basement, there was like a little area where they had two beds set up side by side. And those were two guys that actually went to high school together. So they knew each other. So they had their own little area. And then
just an area, not a room.
It was just, yeah, it was. There was no doors. It was like this kind of a partition area and then two beds. And then the fifth guy had like kind of he brought his loft bed from the dorms and stuff. And set it
and
up
then they're
down
like,
there. And so
not only
had,
that, I'm going to throw a party in this place.
So
too.
the party would take place on the main floor and then kind of outside.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll say the worst party that they had, there was some guys from Martinsville that showed up, which for people that don't know, Martinsville, I don't know if there still is, but there used to be at least like kind of a KKK office that was there. Like it can tend to be kind of a racist area is kind of the, I don't know
of any KKK offices that are just out there operating in the open. Like, but I've never seen one.
Like, well, yeah, I'm I mean, sure it was just kind exist. Of like a division was based out of there is what I was told.
Yeah.
I don't know where it's at.
I just imagine it in a mini mall, like nails, Chinese food, KKK.
Right. Be like, well, they got to buy their stuff somewhere. You know? KKK Mart, where every day's a white sale.
Oh!
That's terrible. But, no, so these kids showed up, and they started some shit with some of the black kids at this party.
Oh, like, I've never seen... Okay, this is what I've never seen, too. Anybody get into a fight just purely on race. Like, I don't like you. You're
there
black.
There was multiple things going on, because they were... They had started talking some shit. Some
Wait,
of friends
who started
the,
it?
The guys that were not... I know they weren't even from... I don't think they even school at IU. I think they were probably just came in or something like that. I don't know. I don't remember the whole story. Now, Grant, keep in mind, this is 15 years ago.
keep in mind this is 1963. Like, oh God.
I was trying to think of like when this happened for me. But so like multiple things were kind of happening about the same time that kind of led to this. But they started talking some shit first. Okay. They had been warned. About the same time, the first keg ran out. Okay.
Anarchy. I remember.
Yeah. So they started getting pissed that they couldn't get a beer. We were waiting for the next keg to show up. Well, I remember my buddy was kind of lit himself. He had been drinking a little bit. He was lit. And I remember he just kind of got loud. Like, he didn't get really obnoxious and mean. He just would be loud to be a smartass and be loud. And I have this visual of him getting back and, like, yelling just like, ah, at the guys.
Having, like, a race fight?
Well, they were bitching at him because he was wanting them to leave.
Oh.
But he picks up the keg. I remember he starts picking up the keg and slamming it. Of course, it was empty, so it was a lot easier to pick up.
But it still looks impressive.
Yeah. And he's like, ah, and bangs it a few times. And I was like, fuck. So they finally start to walk out. Like, we're like, you guys, seriously, you need to go where the cops are going to be called.
Yeah.
So as they're leaving, they have to, there's like a little porch area. Like, you out the front door, and there's a little mini porch. And you have to walk past what is essentially a kitchen window, which is down kind of low.
Mm-hmm.
It's really weird. It's like just really low kitchen windows. And we just hear glass break. And we're just like, God dang it. So they freaking busted out the glass. And of course, still the rest of the party's going on. We just happen to be up there. I'm stone cold sober. Like, I'm not a drinker yet at this point. And I'm just like, holy shit, I'm going to die. Oh my God, this is effed up. And so that happened. Okay, I remember, I'm going to rewind a little bit, because that kind of sets some of the stage for the weekend, okay? I'm still living at home, okay? I didn't want to run off my debit card all weekend, so I went to get some cash. I remember going to get cash at the ATM machine. For whatever reason, I got my PIN number wrong a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
And third time, they take your card.
Yeah, they do.
Like, I kept getting numbers transposed for some reason. I didn't really use the ATM card that much, but I knew I needed cash.
I hardly ever used an ATM.
So I don't have cash. Like, I used it twice, and I'm like, shit, I don't have cash. I'm just going to have to go. I'll figure it out down there. Maybe tomorrow I'll get some cash. I'll try again when I get two more times, and I'll get the right numbers. So we get down there, okay? And I remember, this is right after school started, so I had lived with them for just a little bit when I first started.
In the five-man?
Well, hang on. No. In the summer before school started, I had started working down there, okay? In kind of like their graphics department stuff, mm-hmm. helping them create an online class. That was like their first online class that IU had. It was like a
trailblazer.
It was like the history and cultures and stuff of IU Bloomington or whatever. So I thought it was just going to be a temp thing. I was like, you know, those guys are gone. Do you mind if I crash there for a couple months? I'll pay you guys some rent.
They were gone. Okay.
So they were gone first. Okay. Now, by the time this happened, they had come back. Okay. But I had got used to parking in a certain area. So when I got there that weekend for the party, the actual guest parking was full. So I was like, well, I got nowhere else to park. I'll just park right here, which was like right on the other side. It was like a line. You had guest parking on one side, and then regular parking for everybody else on the other. And it was full, so I just had to come around and park on the other side. It's like, okay, we'll go move my car out later.
Yeah.
Okay, no big deal. So, of course, you know, I have no cash because I almost screwed up my debit card. The windows got kicked in, okay? I remember, I think I had to sleep in my sleeping bag on the floor that night because the guys had come back. I didn't have a bed to sleep in. Beer-soaked floor, like, you walk and
oh,
you
like
hear
spongy?
You
oh,
hear
no.
Well, it wasn't spongy much as it was like
that's spongy.
Like, it was, you hear the crackle and the stick and everything. So I had thrown my sleeping bag on the floor and just kind of like pulled my head up in it because I didn't want my head touching
the floor. Oh
yeah. I remember we woke up and the house was just like trashed.
Mm-hmm.
There was butt prints up on the wall from somebody's jeans.
Ew.
So a girl had been standing up on a table in the corner, and
like,
it must have been, and
like
and her butt was, she'd been leaning up or was grinding her butt up against or whatever.
So it was like the indigo from her jeans?
Yes. Like on she, the... it was, she was hot enough and sweating, I guess. The stain, it stained, it like made her butt wet enough that it stained the wall. So there was like these big butt print stains, like one in, on each wall in the corner. Okay. It's like, shit. So we go out.
How do you get that off? Because this is pre like magic eraser era.
Yeah, I know. I think they would have just had to have painted over it.
Yeah.
But then we go out. It's time for me to leave. And my car's gone. They had already made the rounds
and towed it.
So I have no cash. I don't know where the car is at. Like, we have to call and figure out where the car is at. My buddy has to take me to an ATM machine. And I'm like, oh, my God, I have to get this right. I have to get this right to get the cash to go get my car or else I am fucked. And luckily, I remember getting it the first try because I knew that I had screwed it up. Before I knew which one I had to do. So I got it. And I think, I can't remember. He's like, you want to go get some breakfast? And I'm like,
diligent is that apartment complex? What?
Oh,
they acted like it was New York City up in there.
Oh, they were waiting. That's how they get their money, I guess. Or the tow truck company gets their money because they were waiting. They knew certain time. Let's go. Let's get it done.
Like a kickback. Yeah, like this is party night. We're going to wreck these fuckers morning.
Yeah. But that's intense. So yeah, that was worst weekend ever, I think, down there. So So yeah. So have you ever had any party experiences, period, like college time frame? I figured, you know, that's the one college story that I can get away with telling. I figured, you know, that might be
I used to go to a I wasn't in a sorority, but I was friendly with the guys that were in the fraternity, and they had I dated one of them, and so I would go to their parties sometimes, and they were always having like stoplight parties.
What's that?
Where you wear green if you're single, yellow red if it's complicated, red if you're taken.
Oh wow, I've never heard of that then before. They had okay
angel devil, like these are actually cool concepts for parties. Yeah. They had like angel devil parties where you either come dressed as an angel or a devil, right? And that's just okay. Your little themey. They had other things too. They were always themed. They were pretty cool.
Okay.
Oh, but God, I remember I was just so sheltered, I think, because I was standing out on the porch and just, you know, bullshitting. They had a couch out there.
Right.
Just sitting on the porch couch. And I remember being so grossed out because this couple was making out and then the guy just, I'm just going to reach down this girl's pants and start, like,
wow,
you know,
right there.
Diddling her.
Wow.
Right then and there. And nobody thought much of it. And I was like, ew.
Yeah, so you thought it or you said it?
No, I said it. Like, oh.
Wow.
And then I kind of got the weird look.
like you what's
rude?
Your problem? Yeah. What's the matter? You ain't ever seen somebody diddle somebody else before?
I remember when I get, like, shocked to my core. That was one time where I was like, well, that's just not right, you know? Like, your sense of morality just kicks in right then. You're like, oh.
Welcome to college.
I don't know.
Wow.
I wanted your advice on something. This has nothing to do with college, except it was a guy I once knew in college.
Okay.
So I had...
This is just, like, the guy's perspective, or at least one guy's perspective of advice. Okay. Okay.
So I'll post some crap on my Facebook that gets political sometimes.
I've seen it.
So I post something on there because I write about the electricity grid. That's my job.
Yeah.
And I was just at a conference and maybe you saw this, somebody.
What?
Are you fixing yourself?
Yeah. Well, I had an itch. I figured I'd fix my hair while I'm looking up that way.
Some energy official was like, I think it's incredible that all these natural gas pipelines, I think we're going to look back in 10 years and say, isn't that incredible that we use natural gas as our, you know, because natural gas is super cheap right now.
Right.
And I was like, that's not incredible. That's fucking stupid, like, actually.
We've been doing it forever. You know, it's
It's time for renewables. So I post something to that effect on my
website. I saw the post. I remember liking it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You liked it.
Yeah.
You loved it because you can do that now.
No, I did the angry face.
Oh, the anger face.
I did the anger face because I did it. Yeah.
I use those, and I know it's just, somebody's like, that's just because Facebook wants to track you and know you and surveillance shit. And I was like, yeah, but they got a little angry face on it.
I know. But anyway, go on.
Okay, so this guy starts taking issue with me on it, and I've known him in college. We worked on the paper together. And I was like, isn't it sad that economics, you know, are going to trump, like, what we actually need to do in the world? Like, and I didn't even think this was a liberal thing to say. This is a common sense thing to say. Yeah. Like, we should stop with the coal. We should stop with the natural gas. The prices aren't always going to be this low. It's a finite resource. It's volatile pricing. Why are we doing this? Yeah, it's low now. It's not going to be low in the future.
Yeah.
So pipelines are dangerous. It's a risky, like, why? A lot of them are really old and about to bust on us because we don't spend on infrastructure in this country. So I'm on my soapbox. And I don't think that's a liberal thing to say. And he's, well, okay.
Maybe. No. Keep going. Keep going.
And so he like, blah, blah, blah. It's policy. It's economics. You can't fight economics. That's all this weird shit. Like, and he's always got something to say about, like, the stuff I post that even maybe tends a little bit towards the political. And all right, I have two other friends on Facebook that I worked on the paper with, and they post a lot of political and liberal stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And he never comments on their shit or challenges it or anything like that. But he will, like, go toe-to-toe with me.
Huh.
And I was like, he's a Mormon. Let me get that out of there.
Okay.
And I'm like, why?
I think anything that you say global warming wise, natural wise, like, you know, saving energy wise, anything like that.
Anything environmental,
period, I think is probably inherently a liberal thing almost. I mean, it's stupid that
it is. I feel like it's not.
It shouldn't be.
Right.
But I think that's the...
Well, they demonize the EPA. Everybody,
yeah.
Okay, oh, fair enough. I can see that.
Yeah. So, and the reason that it is because every, you know, you have to look at where our government's at right now. They've got so many, you know, Koch brothers and all these, you know, coal industry.
But why would you do that to, like...
But they've got their hands in politicians' pockets, I guess is the right way. Or maybe it's the other way around. I can't remember. Somebody's got their.
They pretty much are the politicians at this point. Yeah. If you have money, you're a politician.
And that's all the whole supposedly conservative side of things is the side that has that mentality usually because they want their money.
They but gotta why keep, would they gotta my keep... stuff come under such intense scrutiny? And then he's got friends. Is it because I'm a female?
Okay, so it is. So it's guys.
The other two are guys. Okay. Oh, I should have made that clear.
Oh yeah, I was assuming. Maybe guy or girl.
No, they're guys. They're guys, and they're left alone.
Is he? I was wondering if maybe he's closer friends with them that he doesn't want to get on their bad side. But with you, it's just like fuck it, I don't care.
But that's happened before too.
It was before hoes.
Like I know these. I know these white, almost angry all the time dudes. That, you know, either I know him from college or acquaintances or, and like, why do they always have something negative? Like if I see somebody, I see my pro-life friends sticking some shit up.
Mm-hmm.
And then I see him sticking shit up about that Bernie sign cut in half right now. And
I'm
like,
I know. That's not how it works.
I don't post anything. I'm like, okay, you're talking communism. All right. I'll be quiet.
I reel back.
And
so
I don't do,
much.
I don't post on it unless somebody blatantly put a pro-Trump thing up and I was like, oh, you're okay. Fucking stupid. And I couldn't hold back then. But that is the only time. Like, I will leave people alone.
Yeah.
Pretty much. Unless I think they're dangerous.
Yeah, there's Trump. A lot of stuff that I have to just let go because it's like family or friends of family and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Then I'm like, oh, I need to put this person in their place, but I can't because of the fallout that will happen.
You know what's great about my husband? He just doesn't care.
He's like,
if there's relatives out there he doesn't like it, he's like, oh, you son of a bitch. But because somebody had posted like something about the Black Lives Matter versus All Lives Matter.
Yeah.
And I had just found this great like analogy that somebody had posted on Twitter about it.
Yeah.
And they said, saying all lives matter in response to the Black Lives Matter thing is like somebody, like people being at a dinner party. Two people clearly don't have food on their plates.
Right.
And they look up and they're like, well, they should be fed. And somebody's like, everybody should be fed. And I was like, that's a great analogy for it, you know? Yeah. And so he posted that, right? Like, it's got to be like his aunt or something. Yeah. And the next thing you know, her post is just disappeared. Whoo, shit. I'm like, damn, Scott, you're cold. Like, and he's like, I don't care. And I'm like, I do care. I know.
Done. Oh, my gosh. Okay. How long have we been going for?
I don't know.
I can't see a clock.
But no, as far as partying hard college stories.
That's about it.
Oh, man. One time I mixed. Oh, my God. I mixed weed and whiskey and threw up so hardcore that my glasses flew into the toilet. And I was so drunk that I'm just like, no, gotta get those. You know, like I didn't
gotta
even
see.
Like, I need those. I wasn't drunk enough to just stick them back on my face.
You had enough sense to wash them off.
Oh, God, yeah, I've gotten... I don't anymore, though, get drunk like that. Oh, my
gosh. I never get drunk.
I thought I was speaking a language nobody else could understand that night. And they're like, no, Amanda, that's English. And I said, I need a translator for this.
That's funny.
I got so drunk.
Yeah, I've only been drunk twice.
What?
In the first time... The first time was like solely to set out, like, let's see what it takes to get Chad drunk. So I remember being with some friends. Like, I went up to her apartment on the north side of town and planned ahead to spend the night there. So I slept on the couch. And I remember there was, like, you know, several shots that happened. I think they were giving me just, like, some vodka and orange juice and stuff in between. We were playing cards. So I had, you know, had a constant stream going, essentially. And then the girl's whose apartment it was, her boyfriend showed up. Well, then he decided to do a couple shots with me, too. So I'm laying there. So they go to bed. I'm laying on the couch. And it was probably, you know, 15 minutes later after laying down. It's like, oh, this is happening. Like, the room started spinning. Like, okay, something's going to come up. I need some fresh air or something. So she lived on the second floor. So I was like, I go out on the balcony. It's like, oh, fresh air, cold air on my face. Oh, here it comes. And over the balcony, it went into the bushes down below.
Really?
Yep. And I think... Only once or twice, like, I got sick. And after, I was like, oh, I feel good now. Went in, passed right out, slept it off, got up. And, oh, man, my head hurts.
You have to drink water.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
It's because you get severely dehydrated. It took me years to figure that. I was like, oh, man,
my head hurts so bad. Why am I so sore? And it's because I didn't drink any water. I had no clue. They didn't tell me. And I didn't know to ask.
There were some, when I first met my husband, there were some unfortunate photos online of me. I wanted to go as the St. Pauli girl.
I don't know what that is.
The St. Pauli girl on the beer. She's got the beer. She's like a German.
Oh,
and she's got
okay.
like a lace-up corset and okay. her hair is up. She maybe got a little heart necklace.
Gotcha. Okay. I can.
There were some unfortunate pictures of me because we had gone to somebody's Halloween party in a barn. And they had set up a pole. So, like, there was this photo of me tagged, like, flying around a pole in this beer girl costume getaway. And I'm like, that's not who I am. I couldn't. He's like, wow. And
he's like, what have I gotten myself into?
My friends and I had gone skinny dipping before. Well, it was like a yearly thing to go skinny dipping, but it was in the dark, up in the woods. Everybody was drunk. Nobody remembers what anybody looked like or... And I was trying to convince him that wasn't... So he must have thought I was crazy.
You and I have lived very different lives. I'm interested to see all these stories that, like, come from here on out to compare to my life. Because, wow, I didn't...
That's not that...
I didn't do shit.
I really... It's not that... It's not that nuts. You just... I don't know.
That's... Yeah, I never... I never
was trying to...
Okay, hang on. I got to ask us though. So how does this work? Like, do you strip down before you jump in, or do you jump in and then while you're in the water then strip down?
It was the plan all along to go skinny. It was
because I'm thinking logistically, like, afterwards you would want dry clothes. So I mean, in my head,
it's summer, and they have a raft. It's somebody's really private property too.
Okay.
Like, it's somebody's hunting property that incidentally has, like. And it's not even a nice, like, there's seaweed at the bottom, too. So you're, like, running through the weeds and stuff to get it there. And I hate that. It was the goal because the party host, he was my boyfriend's friend.
Okay.
My ex. And he had gotten it into his head that, like, that's what's going to happen to make this a really epic party. He was always trying, like, he's so cute. He was always trying to, like, what can I do to top this party from the last party? He's like, the last party was good. But I need greatness. Like, he would post, like, these really lengthy Facebook posts about how great the party was. And we all got way into it. Like, we're here to make your party great. Like, his name was Mad Mike. Like, that's what's really... I don't know just to call him Mike because he was Mad Mike.
Okay.
So, and he would, like, get real excited and be like, there's 30 days till this epic party. And we're like, yeah!
It's like, so, I need...
It wasn't that we even wanted...
And a trampoline and... Porta potty, obviously. We need a place for people to strip down. No porta potty, just the woods. Yeah,
just the woods, which there were a lot of. A potato gun.
Okay.
Which I refused to touch that thing. It was like a PVC contraption.
Oh yeah,
homemade. With the hairspray. I was like, no, fuck no. They fill it with the hairspray
and then light it.
Yeah. And then the potato, and it doesn't come out whole. Like it's like. So he said the thing that would make this really epic, above all, you know, is just going and it was so Midwest. It's like a Kid Rock song, really.
Oh my god!
It was so, yeah. We were really like kind of hillbillies, and so we were like, "That's what we got to do." And so he comes around like, "It's time," and we're like, "All right." So we all just go into our tents and come out naked, like it's pitch dark. So we're like. It's time. And the stupid thing is, like, we don't just strip that. We just come out of our tents naked, like, here, we're here. We're ready for you, Mad Mike. And so we all just, like, ran down there. And then we just got out, and then just clothes were put back on. Oh, wow, nothing sexual. It was really odd.
We hung out with such different people. Like, I went to a really small school. There was, like, 36 of us that graduated
from
my class.
Yeah,
we
compared that before.
And my group of friends was like,
oh, this
half
wasn't
of that.
High school. This was college. Oh,
okay.
Too. So,
but just thinking of like the group of friends, you know, the wildest thing that we ever did is like we TP'd a teacher's house.
I never
because he told us that we could go TP
his
house.
Oh, I've
heard
this story. Yeah.
So it's just like that's what we were like. We did something wild, but only with permission. Like we were just the good, wholesome kids.
My brother was weird. Awful. My brother was an awful, like straight up vandal. Like this kid was pretty nasty to him. He just stuck a knife in the side of his pool, his above ground pool,
and it just
him over. Like did that in the middle of the night.
Oh
god. His friend wanted McDonald's one night, so he's like, here we go, and I guess he. I don't even think he was drinking, but he's like, I'm just going to sit in lawn job McDonald's for 5 solid minutes because there was an empty lot to the side of McDonald's. So he just sits there like, in his Jeep. And then he decides to go through the drive-thru after that, like casually, like, I want some chicken nugs. And they were like, the McDonald's employees were really cool. They wait until he gets to the second window. They hand him the food and they're like, we've called the police. And he's like, better go. Like, those are some sweet employees. Like, they probably watched him the whole time. Like, well, I've worked up an appetite.
Guys, fire up the grill. This guy's going to be hungry. Oh, my gosh. That's a good story.
Yeah.
And that's what I hope to get out of this show, I think, is the document. Just the stupid stuff that we do. And if anybody hears this, if you guys want to share anything...
I don't do a whole lot of stupid stuff anymore.
See, I never really did.
Oh, my family
I mean, there was a few
up,
things here and there maybe that I'm sure I'll think of.
But. We go up on the river and get real wild. Canoeing. And it's family stuff.
Yeah.
My brother got
it's
out of hand.
It's different than when with your family, though.
Well, no, my brother kind of got out of hand when we were skiing. And my dad just passes him. He's like, calm down or I'll put you down. And I thought that was so funny. Like, my dad's still going to put him down, like, after all these years.
I don't remember how old I was, but I remember I got in trouble for something. I was, like, probably in junior high or something. And I said some shit to my mom. It'd be, like, you know, talking back or whatever. And I swear my mom, like, picked me up and body slammed me. Like, she's like, you will listen to me. Like, you're not too big for me to put you in your place.
I didn't get in trouble in school. Like, never.
Yeah, I didn't either.
It took me a while. I was pretty much a silent kid. And then it only took me after, like, pretty much sadly after graduation before I'm like, oh, it's okay to be a person and, like, talk, you know? So.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, I think that's a good spot to stop.
Okay.
For now. I mean, before, because I can't think in my head initially of where I could take that conversation, unless you have something else.
I have nowhere to go. Okay. If this is like, we got to talk about wild party stories. I mean, hey. I don't have.
Well, and I didn't either. But that was just like one thing.
Oh, we're gonna find a defined topic each time.
We can find a defined topic, and then where it goes, we'll see. So, you know, eventually we might talk about cars.
Ooh, I got nothing to say.
Just like the different cars we had, and then stories about.
Oh, that's cool.
Or, you know, pets we've had.
No, I can't. Our favorite movie. We have to talk about pets.
Yeah, or movies we've had, or just jobs, like stupid job stories. You know, anything that I think people could relate to. I think is where I want this show to go.
So much of my life is embarrassing, though.
And that's what makes it great. So, anyway, I think this inaugural episode has probably gone on long enough. I hope that there are people that's going to watch this. I hope you guys like it. Because I want to do this for a little bit more. I mean, this is more... I think for me, this is something... Like, I know I have all these stories that I would like to have...
Document for
posterity reasons, and because they're fun stories. I mean, I know how to tell a story. If nothing else, I know how to tell a story. Mm-hmm. I think, and I like to tell stories, and I love to talk, and you know, this is a way to do that. And it's something more light, you know, versus the heavy stuff that we tend to talk about on the other show. You know, we're gonna eventually. Have a splash screen right now. We got nothing. I'll just come up with some generic text.
That's me. I'm gonna try. I got my once a month thrift store shopping tomorrow.
Yeah,
I'm only allowed once a month.
And we could talk about that at some point too.
I love that.
She's a thrift store shopper, big time.
Yeah. So I'm allowed to go out once a month, and that tomorrow's my big day, or Saturday if I miss it. But okay, and then this weekend. I gotta draw a logo.
Yeah. She's gonna attempt to draw something for us, I think.
Okay.
I hope so. Guys, we leave you. I have no fun, you know, outro tag or anything to say yet. I'll think of something. But in the meantime, thanks for listening. We hope you're still here, and we hope you'll come back. Have a good night.
Bye.